Okay, this video is on the Hobbycraft 1/48 scale La-5FN. This was a fun build. It's going to be the last build I do. Hobbycraft is very, I like that company. They're old molds, so they're very incorrect. What it happens is that with the LA-5FN that they offer you, it's actually the LA-7, and they just give you a hood scoop and little different trinkets that the LA-5 had, but it's actually their LA-7 mold. And therefore, if you know anything about these airplanes, you know that the LA-7, the front wing is very different than the LA-5. So what I did on this kit, I extensively did a lot of scratch building and correcting. I corrected the front main wing. The kit, I bought it for like about $5, about maybe 14 years ago at a show, and it came with a True Details cockpit set and a old Edward photo etch set, which was pretty good for that time. But even the True Details cockpit set came inaccurate, as if you know anything about the LA-5FN, which was the bubble top kind of version, not the Razorback, it had radio equipment right behind the main cockpit, right behind the pilot. And the kit doesn't model this, and neither did True Details, so I took it upon myself to scratch build all this area. And the reason you know is because the Zvezda kit, which is an excellent accurate kit, comes with all of this stuff right behind the pilot. So what happened here was that I had to scratch build the whole rear part of the cockpit with the radio equipment. I scratch built the armored glass pilot shield right behind his seat there, that goes inside the under the canopy in between the radio equipment and the cockpit. I scratch built the main gun sight. I scratch built the SHVAK 20mm cannons outside nacelles and inside with gun primers. I scratch built the cockpit cables and what have you. Brake lines were scratch built. The warming fins behind the propeller were scratch built. They're actually warming fins. A lot of people confuse them for a fan or what have you. No, these things actually, what they did is that they were hand cranked, and they would extend and cover all the air going to the engine, so that in the winter the engine could heat up faster. Once the engine was hot enough, then the pilot would hand crank them down, and they would open up completely to let air flow to the engine to continue cooling. But it was a way to get the airplane started for the cold battles of the Eastern Front much quicker. Simple engineering, and the Russians have always been simple about their engineering. Again, the kit I modeled was the actual kit that comes in the Hobbycraft kit, which is Popokov's 01. Now, the decals were horrible, so I had a whale of a time finding decals, and I finally found print scale decals, which I'm no fan of. If you look at my decal video, I'll tell you that they disintegrated into a million pieces and what have you. But you're going to have bumps in every model or whatever. We overcame them, and I'm very pleased with the results of this model. I like the airplane. I've always liked these airplanes. I like the camouflage schemes on them, the colorful schemes on them. There was arguments about whether the star was really yellow or whether the... Well, I am going to provide a picture of the actual airplane with Popokov standing right next to it. And you can clearly see, even in black and white, that the main star on the side of the fuselage was outlined in yellow. And a lot of people don't put the Order of Lenin banner on the cowling. I like it, so I provided it. Again, I did extensive scratch building. You're going to see the radiator, the oil cooler radiator grill under the nose. That was scratch built. The main propeller spinner air tube that comes out through the middle, that was scratch built. I also scratch built main and rear landing gear doors, because the kit ones were horrible. They were just too thick. Scratch built the brake lines. I mean, extensive the strut shocks that hold the struts open, that was scratch built. And different things that I did. Just too much to list, but overall I'm pleased with the results. And the weathering and the paint scheme and everything came out pretty good. I like it. I will not be building another Hobbycraft LA5FN. I'm building a Hobbycraft MiG 17, which I'm gonna put in a Polish markings. But the LA5FN, I'm probably only gonna build one more, and that's a Zvezda. I've already bought the Zvezda kit. As far as for an LA7, which I haven't built, I'm going to build one also, and I bought a Gavia kit, which is very good. So I'm pretty much done with Hobbycraft as far as the LA Lavochkin series of Soviet fighters of World War II. But nevertheless, here's the video. Here's the final works. I hope you enjoy it. PM me if you have any questions, comment, rate, and have fun with modeling before anything, okay? Panzerkill 13 out.
Sure.
Okay, that was the video. I hope you enjoyed it. My first propeller-driven Soviet fighter of World War II ever. As you can see, some of the other aircraft, I mainly built German stuff. And a couple of British subjects. Currently working on Tamiya 148 scale BF-194 in Helmut Wick. Battle of Britain markings for the group build on Facebook pages, Modeling World War II Facebook page. I want to give a shout out to them. They're great people. We're having great fun on that page. I want to give a shout out to the people on Tamiya Model Magazine Facebook page, the Facebook Scale Model Society Facebook page, the Plastic Model Builders Group Facebook page, the World War II Diorama Art Facebook page. I mean, there are so many scale aircraft Facebook page, 148 scale fighters Facebook page. There are so many of them. Get on there, look up, and join. I mean, there's a lot of fun. What I like about the Facebook pages is that there's people on there every night, and you get comments. If you're doing good, you get compliments, comments, questions in real time. I like it here, too, but I'm not on here all the time, and, you know, sometimes I'll take a while to get back to you, but on Facebook, we're on there pretty much every night looking at each other's stuff, rooting for each other, talking with each other. We have our military model graveyard selling page, which is auctions from Friday to Sunday, 10 p.m. Eastern time to 10 p.m. Eastern time in real time live. I mean, people are bidding in real time right there, and everybody's great. You have a lot of fun. People start battling over model kits. There's great deals, better deals than eBay. Great fun. Come join us. Join the group and get in there and join the fun every Friday through Sunday. Great people on that page. They're partnered with a Modeling World War II Facebook page. And again, you can see all of our stuff that we're doing in real time. We're posting stuff every day there. That's where we post our progress shots and stuff like that every day for all of our stuff that we're doing. Again, I'm doing that. I'm doing a Battle of Britain build. I'm also building a 135th scale TriStar Panzer IV Detach, which was on the amphibious tank for Operation Sea Lion. I'm also building a JV-44 Red 1 FW-190 D9 Tamiya in 148 scale Dora with the red bottom and white stripes. I'm building a Hasegawa 148 scale BF-109 F4 Walter Nowotny White 8. I like that scheme. I'm trying to find the decals. Can't find them anywhere. The decals in the kit were horrible. They dried up over the years or what have you. So I got to try to find the decals to that. But that's some of the stuff that I'm doing. And again, come join us on Facebook. Look for us on Facebook. It's free to join. It's great fun. I hope you like the video. Rate, comment. If you have any questions, let me know. PM me. And as of now, happy modeling and Panzer Kiel out.